Do you have any idea what the code might be?
No. So we should probably see if Marianne hid anything before we go trying to guess.
There you are, trusty crowbar.
There are like a million possibilities. Probably quicker just...
I think I'm just gonna break this open.
I mean, really? This is all pretty elaborate. I think she was trying to tell us something.
Whatever she wants us to know, it's clearly in here. I'm done with the rest of it. Whoa.
Did it just get darker in here?
Ollie, she knows. Why does she have a photo of that tree locked in here?
What? Who is that?
Leo Ronan.
She had a baby before us?
December 2nd, 1992 to January 31st, 1993. God, he was so young.
We had a brother. Why didn't she tell us about him? Why didn't she tell us any of this?
I mean, it's fucking terrible. That's why. Allie, did we do the right thing opening this?
We did. It's better we know what happened, even if it's hard. And there's one more thing we need to see.
Are you sure?
Yes. Come on, let's go to the dock. It's time to finish this. You really want to go? You sure we've seen everything?
Either way, I'm ready for this to be over.
Me too. What are we waiting for? I want to know who was here that night. Let's try and remember who Marianne was arguing with. You knew how bad it got out here. How little... You tried to burn down our barn and knocked Tyler unconscious. You were here that night. You saw Marianne and Tyler.
So what do we do now?
We tell him he's gotta fix the mess.
You failed us, Tom. You need... That was convenient for you, huh? You preyed on her.
Your mother was... That night...
Something's off because he put this in your head.
I'm going to kill you! I'm going to kill you! I'm going to kill you!
No, don't do this! Mom, no! Allison, this isn't... what...
Tom was lying. Marianne couldn't face being separated from her kids again. And the only way to make sure that never happened was for all of us to go together. I know it in my heart. I saved you. I saved us.
I know. You did the right thing. You want to go back inside?
Yeah.
Hey, peep what I just found downstairs. What do you think? Will it have aged well, or just gone bad? Cheers, I guess.
I can't believe Tom thought we'd buy that story. And that I almost did.
Yeah, I still can't believe he and Marianne. What the hell did she see in him?
She was probably just really, really lonely after she lost Leo.
I could never get that lonely.
Listen, with everything that's been going on, it got me thinking. About our voice. Like, that maybe we should stop using it.
What?
I just don't trust it, and I think we'll be better off without it. This morning, I kept getting these horrible visions of you and Marianne and Eddie.
Visions? Like our memories?
Yeah, but different. It was all my worst thoughts brought to life. You were in my bedroom saying I abandoned you. Eddie called me a snake.
I'm sorry. I should have been there for you.
It's okay. I was the one who walked out. I can't let that happen again.
I don't think it will. Something's been pushing us to find answers. And now we have them. Maybe I'm wrong. And if it stays bad, we can stop. But I really want to keep what makes us, us.
The Mad Hunter was forced to remain below the lake with the Moon Hag, but she did not kill him, because even reduced to just one hand, he was too useful a servant. Lo, he plotted the day he would emerge.
Brothers and sisters?
To once again hunt the wise princess and earn back his left hand.
Always.
And that is the story of how the crafty goblins rescued the wise princess from the Mad Hunter.
Hey, it's me.
Hey. Everything okay?
Oh, everything's fine. I just came back from shopping and thought I'd call.
Well, it's good to hear your voice. What's going on?
All right. Time for me to get going.
Okay, but real quick. Everything good with the house?
Yeah, I'm starting to make it mine. To tame it, if you will.
You think you made the right call staying?
Yeah, I think so. Even after everything. This feels like where I need to be right now.
Maybe that's a good thing to write about then.
You know what? That's not a bad idea, actually.
Okay, but you better give me credit if you do.
Will do. Love you.
Love you too, sis.
Really love having to drive that 20 extra miles for groceries. But better that than the awkwardness of going to the Vecchi's.
Hey, Allison. Guess you're not answering your landline either. Just wanted to check in and see if we're still on for dinner tomorrow. I'm making my special Eddie-licious fish tacos. Oh, sorry, gotta run. Mayor Scrooge just walked into my office. Love you, Little Moose.
Hey, Princess. Well, I'm doing like you asked and calling ahead to let you know I'm on my way out to replace that door. So, that's up. See you soon.
donate my shit for all I care. At least someone got what they deserved. to work. Come on, Allison.
You got this, sis.
Let's hope.
A friend? What is that? The princess frowned, for she realized that the two tiny thieves were as lonely as she was. A friend is someone you love and care for. Someone you would never hurt. Yeah, right. Once upon a time, in an ancient and deep forest, there lived a solitary goblin in a big wooden house. That goblin had not always been so solitary. She had a twin, and when they were younger, they were inseparable. Together, they rescued princesses and outsmarted ice trolls and even trapped a mad hunter. But as she grew older, the goblin sister decided that she'd had enough of adventures. So while her brother went out to explore the world, she stayed behind as guardian of the big wooden house. For it is not on all of us to adventure. Some must stay behind to tell the story and to hold shelter for those who may come back, and those who never left.